There you go. A lovely morning here on the Rush Talk. My name is Miles Ramiti, and we are here up the hour of 10 o'clock. And believe wherever you are watching this broadcast, I would remind you, by the way, that you can still download the app, New Vision Digital app, to be able to watch all our programs here on Urban. Of course, those of you watching watching us from social media, we appreciate you. Our socials, of course, Urban TV Uganda. Of course, our Twitter, Urban TV Uganda. Join the discussion, of course, with the hashtag Rush Talk. With me this morning, of course, I'm, as usual, you know, first of all, I have my sister here, Aunt Jovita, coming through. You know, she likes so many kids. She's a fan of kids and children as well. On the other side, I have my good friend, the VC, Victoria University. I understand there's something going on, but he will tell us anyway later on. Guys, we don't have much time. I would want you to say hello, and then we'll continue with our discussion this morning.
Hello.
Starting with you. Usually you are here with us on Monday. So
hello, viewers. Glad that you're watching us, and we expect you to keep the tab on as you hear what we're going to discuss this morning.
And good morning, Miles.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Jovita and Urban TV viewers. My name is Dr. Lawrence Mganga, like my good friend Miles said. I am glad that I'm here. Hopefully, we are going to make you proud. We are going to have a conversation, all of us, and we stand to benefit. So thank you for tuning in. Stay with us.
I'll start with you, Doctor. What's going on with you know, the university? What's going on? What are you up to? It's been a while you came here, by the way.
Okay.
Whenever you come here, you come with something new. So what's happening? What's
going on? Two things.
Yes.
I am a Christian, right?
Yes, you are.
So we've been... there was a mother who has been pregnant, so she gave birth recently. So as a university, we are a renewed university. If you're a Christian, we are born again, we have a charter.
Wow.
So I want to tell Ugandans
congratulations
for that. That as recent as I think 19th July, His Excellency the President appended his signature on our charter, justifying that we are a university that fulfills all the requirements that are needed by the law of the land, with all the quality standards required by expected of every university in Uganda, in the region, in Africa, and internationally. So now you have a home, Ugandans.
Wow.
Victoria University has charter. But number two.
Yes.
We have, I mean, for us, we have chosen to set the pace for others. Now, let me take you back. All of us have been to school.
Yes, yes.
Jovita loves kids, nurtures them, and they end up at university.
Yes,
she has
yes,
been
yes.
in university. Remember how you went to school and graduated? The only thing I remember in every graduation, I've been fortunate to be at three different universities and graduated. In different programs, but everything is characterized by one thing. You expect the dean of students to read your name, you jubilate a little bit, but
and sit.
But the problem is in the long wait, especially when a university is graduating 10,000 students. Before they reach your name, you're already sleeping, your parents are sleeping, you're just tired. And another problem of even you, when you are supposed to be celebrated or to celebrate, but you are there, bored and sleepy.
Yes.
We are changing that at Victoria University.
Really?
Changing the tradition of graduating.
Okay.
We are saying that these are people who are supposed to be celebrated. Their talents, their competences, their abilities, the skills they have acquired. Why do we put them to, they say, why do you give them Piriton? You know that small tablet that makes people sleep?
Yes.
Why do you make them sleep? Entertain them, celebrate them, move them around. Let them feel like we don't even need an after party. We are going back home. We are equalizing everyone.
Yeah,
we are saying,
you seem to be enjoying this.
Yes, we are saying that COVID has left everyone almost empty financially.
Yeah.
We are saying you don't need to have money to have a party at home. You don't need, if you're rich, we are even giving you a better experience.
Yes.
So we are saying, come September 3rd.
Yes.
That is this Saturday, coming Saturday. We have put in place everything you have ever dreamt of.
Okay.
You'll find a lineup, for example, of artists whose talents we want to celebrate. from the Ben, from Spice Diana, King Saha, the Vixen, Baninas, and the list is too much,
okay.
Like around 12.
Yes, yes.
But in the Salvador's, the Wijkbender, all of them, they are also going to tell you their story.
Okay.
Why did they end up who they are? If you think, some people think that being educated is going to school and you acquire as many degrees as possible.
Yes, I argue
that that's not correct. Education is you understanding who you are, find yourself, your natural abilities, your interests, your passion, bring them to work and solve society's problem. If you do that, you are educated.
So that's education to you?
That's education.
I would want to get to Aunt Jovita here, which is extremely, extremely happy with what you're saying. Aunt Jovita, are you excited about what Dr. Mugangi is saying? Also, where the president says, you know, we need to get back to where children should study, what they're supposed to be doing in the field, and then getting back to the old way. And now I see you saying, you know what Dr. Mugangi is saying is the way to go.
I really want to appreciate what doctor has said. Because in a very, very, in my mind, I've been thinking we've been grooming children and taking them through an education that doesn't fit their passion.
Very true.
Really?
When you study something you have passion about,
something you cherish,
your inner talent, if it is nurtured and developed, when you're placed in a job of that section,
yes,
whatever it is,
yes,
you are bound to excel.
They call it being in your zone.
Being in your space, being in your zone.
Okay.
You are bound to excel. And how does this happen? When the human resource is in the right place, then you know that there is going to be functionality in that organization. Ramiti, we shouldn't be placed where there is a vacancy. Even if I just come, but can I be placed where my talents have, where I have passion, where my talent has been identified, nurtured, and developed?
That's very true.
People, if we do this, it is one of the best things that we'll ever do for our generations to come.
So you agree that we should change whatever we're doing, probably we now try to get to the other side?
Yes, I agree, but also we won't just drastically do
true.
It.
Yeah, absolutely. True.
We have to go gradually.
Yes, yes.
We
yes.
have to prepare places where we are going to have all this work. We have to have the resources available, both human and financial, to have this new education system we are dreaming about to work. We can't have an overhaul immediately without putting certain things in place.
That's correct.
And this is where I come in. I am just saying, like us who love children, we've seen these children, we've seen them grow. You see a child is in a family, because everybody is a doctor, we expect all the children to be doctors.
I'm telling you.
My
family, I was there, probably the engineer. And so should be other, you know, people coming through.
And they become engineers. I want to applaud Dr. Omangino of the Heart Institute.
Yes.
All his children are medical related. His last born said, no, I want to be a lawyer.
Correct.
Wow. She performed and got distinctions in all the subjects. Not that she passed sciences or arts alone. She got distinctions, had 11 at Mount St. Mary's Namagunga.
Yes.
But she said, me, I want to be
a lawyer.
And everyone was saying, but you've passed sciences. How can you forego? She said, no, I have passed everything and my interest is here. This is a girl, once she executes her dream, she's going to excel at whatever she does, despite what the family background is. Now, for us parents, because we look at our children, you say, in P2, I think this boy is going to be an engineer. And we push him. We don't try to identify his other talents. his innate, his inborn gift,
yes,
which we need to enhance, nurture, and develop, and it becomes something big. If we were doing this, and I know Ramiti, yes, even if we are engineers, I think Ramiti is an artist.
Mm-hmm.
So why don't I support Ramiti in this direction?
Yes.
Expose him to his role models who are artists.
Correct.
Direct him in this school of art school and help him achieve his dream. I think this is the best thing that is going to happen to this country.
Mm.
And I think the children who are watching us are saying, wow. Because we have children who are sports.
Yes,
sports guys. And we are pushing them, man, you first bring my doctorate, my medicine, what, and then you go. But we have a number of people who have achieved that, who have gotten those degrees, and they've brought them and given them back to their parents, and they've gone for their dreams.
Yeah.
So why do we waste that space?
Very true.
Why do we waste that time? Why are we wasting all these resources on someone who is not interested in what we are trying to push for? Why aren't we giving people a chance to do what they love? And for people to do what they love, they have to have centers where they should go. I would call them the talent incubation centers, where they should go and appreciate what they want to be. Not to learn, but to appreciate and say, oh, so if I want to be an engineer, I'll go for the talent incubation center, be there for the holiday, learn how machines work. Am I ready for this? Why do we wait for them to reach university and then do internship? Exactly. We should start now.
Exactly.
We should start now.
Exactly.
Every holiday senior, one who wants to be an engineer, should have an incubation center where they go, learn about machines. It's not something that, it's not classwork. They should go and appreciate. A machine operates like this? Oh, am I ready? Yes. If it's about medicine, am I ready to cut a frog and see the intestines? Am I ready to do whatever they call it for a dead person? But am I ready?
Not autopsy.
Am I ready? Just to appreciate the systems. Go back to school when you are well informed that what I'm pursuing, these are the stages I'll go through.
Okay.
Not necessary to go for internship when you're already in the thing and you're seeing things and you're seeing them for the first time and you're now trying, you're almost getting squinted. Your eyes are here, they are not there. You're looking at this. You're like, oh my God, did I make the right choice? So as parents, we need to give our children the opportunity.
Okay. Or think they really should praise. Dr. Lawrence, back to you. Do you anything want to add on Jovita's?
I could not ask for a better conversation. Thank you so much. I really know why you have a passion for kids. And that's where it starts.
Oh, yeah.
You lose them at that age, you get 200,000 people who graduate every year and they will never work anywhere because they have been conditioned to look for a job because no one tapped into their passion. No one tapped into their abilities. Now, I'm a living example of that. Grew up, I was told, oh yeah, going into economics, you're going to work in Bank of Uganda.
You know,
you're going to, that's where money is, right? Go do it. I did economics, did a master's degree in economics. I was very productive, actually. People who saw me working as an economist, as a senior policy advisor as an economist, right, thought actually that it was my, but every day at 5, I could go to a classroom at a university to part-time and teach.
What?
The calling is haunting you. So I ended up there until I said, you know what, this is it. Pursued another master's in education that I felt, a PhD in education, a postdoctoral in education that has made me who I am. That was me finding myself, Okwezula, they say, Newezula. There are so many kids out there. So many of them, they are telling them, please find X. But does really finding X mean you're going to find a job?
Not really.
Is there a relationship?
Not really.
No. If you are in your zone, like she, very well articulated, you push boundaries. You tend to find things. Like you look at a problem, and there are so many ways you want to do it, to solve that problem. Like, you are these C students. You know, there are two students in this world, a C student and an A student.
Okay.
Yeah. There is a great philosopher, Alan Watts, an educationist as well. He said, like, if you're so inquisitive, if you're so passionate about something, if you're so imaginative and you're literate, sometimes you don't need to go and get a degree. No, maybe if you want to become a teacher, if you want to become a physician, if you want to become a lawyer, go and get your degree, because a teacher, you're going to teach these things. Mm. But there are these other things you can sit and do, like she has been saying. Do them.
Mm.
Real world. Solve a problem. That's when you're going to become what? Someone productive, a human capital that the country can depend on. And I applaud His Excellency the President. Yes, it may have come late, but it's never too late.
There's a
right?
Point.
There's always a starting point.
Yes.
I am glad that he justifies what we have been doing at Victoria University. Yes, we started. Yes, I don't shy to say that.
Yes.
I have been making noise about an outdated education system, a colonially packaged system that they left with us, and they have moved away from it, and we are cherishing it.
Exactly.
I am glad he pronounced that, and once he says that, that means the minister, the Honorable Minister of Education, the First Lady,
yes,
of course she also says the same, husband and wife.
Yes, they
are in unison, they speak the same. So I expect change. Let me tell you why. This morning I was compiling a list of things, if my phone can allow me, I was making a list of things that schools don't teach us,
uh-huh.
that they don't teach our children,
okay.
right? That
yes.
have actually motivated me from being an educator.
The school never told us.
Exactly.
Yes.
Number one, they don't teach you at school how to love someone. Yet you're going to struggle the entire life trying to love someone.
We are not told this in school.
To stay in a marriage. No one tells you that.
Yes,
they
yes.
don't teach you how to be famous. Some people want to be famous. They are
I'm
on Facebook
you.
Or Instagram.
Exactly.
Everyone
yes.
is struggling, likes and everything.
Yes.
No one is teaching you all those things.
And that's, let me cut you
yeah, yeah, yeah.
And that's why we are seeing people trying to take nude pictures.
You know.
Because they want to get numbers.
Exactly.
Yes. To get likes.
But
to
can
get,
you
yes.
be yourself
ending
as
up
decent as you were?
Exactly.
And still become
Thank
famous?
You. Ending up destroying themselves. Right? So they don't teach you how to be rich. Find X.
Never.
Not how to find money.
Never.
Yet the end result is to
is
find
money.
Yes.
Right? They don't teach you the dangers of poverty for you to know them as early as possible. No one tells you all that. You know, I still have, yeah.
Okay.
The other thing is that they don't teach you how to walk away from someone who don't love you any longer.
People who don't make you.
Yes.
People who pull
you, know,
you back.
You know, they
stuff.
Don't teach you how to know what's going on in someone else's mind.
Yes.
But that's what we want to know. We struggle. They don't teach you what to say when your beloved one is dying. This is
oh,
real
yeah.
life.
Yeah.
Right?
Indeed.
They don't teach you anything worth knowing.
Indeed.
You know what the system does?
No.
You know this saying that tell me who
you
your
are.
Friends are?
Mm-hmm.
Then I'll know who you are.
Mm.
When you come to university, you're almost all the same age.
Yes.
So that means what are you going to learn from a fellow 19-year-old or 20?
Yes.
The system does not entertain Miles to work with a 17-year-old because that's real life. We are going to work together. We create an artificial environment called a classroom, and then we put the lamp these young people in this classroom for 3 or 4 solid years.
Yes.
And then we tell them, as a vice chancellor, I'll make a speech and say, we have given you everything. Go out in the world and make us proud. But they have gone with 0 years of what?
Experience.
And yet the employer, no employer whatsoever,
yeah.
unless he or she is your dad,
yes.
will ever ask for 0 years of employment.
I'm telling you.
What kind of dilemma is this? I am glad the president came forward and make like we feel vindicated of what we have been talking
yes,
about
yes, yes, yes.
on a daily basis. And now, if I was driving, I would keep now accelerating. That this is the right thing that I have to do as a vice chancellor of a university. She talked about internships. Where in the world would you think that someone who has done a program of 3 years will benefit from just 3 months of internship. Okay. And do you know what they do when they go there?
No.
Oh, yeah, if you're the boss, can you make for me tea? Pick for me lunch. You are actually interning in how to do errands.
That's it.
Exactly. We changed that. We are saying, much as we love you as our student, don't sit in our classroom for 5 days. What are you doing there? Please, 2 days, but we put you somewhere in a real world job. So go to Stambik, go to this, where I'm talking about, go to Vision Group, go everywhere where we have these partnerships.
Yes.
They have accepted to take on these students, and these entities also receive free labor. Mm-hmm. Teach them experience, because you're going to need them.
Yes.
Right? So we can't pretend to be the educators. We have to co-educate with the industry. So such that you leave our university with your transcript academic, but you also need another transcript, which is of skills and competences that you obtained from the real world of work. All right? So you live with 2 years of experience at least, or a year of experience to start somewhere. Most of the time, you're not going to look for a job, because now you understand the dynamics of creating something, solving a problem, and then once you solve that problem with a solution, you monetize it and earn money from it. That's the new way of looking at education.
Interesting facts here. You can actually join the conversation if you can ask any question. Our hashtag on Twitter is Rush Talk Urban TV. We have here, of course, a senior man here, Mr. Dr. Lawrence Muganga, and of course, Angie Vita, who has actually been through. And
I also have a doctorate in looking after children.
I agree. Wow. Yes.
Angie Vita,
amazing.
You guys seem to be raising serious issues here.
I want to tell you that I think this is a dream come true. You know, us who meet these children at a young stage, we've seen them grow. You hear what they are saying. There are things they tell us that they never tell their parents.
True.
They disclose so much to us. Someone tells you, my dad is pushing me to do this. Manjovita, I'm a footballer.
I know.
And you don't know how to address it to the parent. Because we think football is for the...
Those
who have failed.
Yes.
You know?
Someone says, but you see, at every family function, I am the MC. I think this is a job I can do well if I'm supported. But everyone is telling me I should go and do, become. Those numbers, yes, I need them. But I think my...
This is what I feel.
This is what I feel.
Yes.
But they are telling me if you're going to be an MC, okay, that too as a family.
Obeloti MC.
I know. You know, how do I identify with you? Me as a parent, me, a professor.
You know.
How do you tell me my son is an MC? And yet these are the jobs that are bringing in revenue.
Yes.
People are happy doing these jobs. For instance, me, in my family, they wanted me to be a lawyer.
Oh.
But
I would imagine you being a lawyer.
I can't imagine what I would be doing there. But in my inner being,
you'd be a lawyer for kids.
Teacher,
kids, right.
I felt being a teacher was a reward for me. I was always teaching.
Yeah.
We were in National Housing in Mbarara. Those were 30 blocks. But all the children, rich, poor, average, wherever, they all converged at our home. And I would be teaching as young as 9 years. Time came when I was going to university. I didn't make it to university the first time. So my mom said, you know, I can pay for it. I said, Mom, I'm going to pay for a education at university. By then it was 600,000. But National Teachers College Masindi is admitting me as a government child, as on government sponsorship. Why don't I go to NTC Masindi, study well, perform well, excel, and go to Makere as a mature? My mom could not believe that. But I insisted. I went to Masindi, studied my 2 years, I got a first class diploma, and ended up at Makere. They actually came for me. I didn't go to Makere to apply.
They did come for you.
They came for me from Hoima. They found me teaching in a classroom at the seminary. And they said, no.
Seminary.
No. St. John Bosco Seminary.
Yes.
I was the only female teacher in the seminary. And wherever I entered, everyone would be looking like a lady has entered.
I know.
And I was their age. I was just 19, 20.
I know. It's interesting to be in a seminary school, you know.
I would find all the boys seated on the veranda, and I didn't know where to pass to enter the classroom.
What?
They are waiting to see a girl. And I wasn't an ugly girl. Let me tell you, I was a very beautiful girl.
I like that. That's very true.
So,
no, you are not, let me correct you. Mm-hmm. You are not, you said as if it is in the past. Mm-hmm. You are still beautiful.
Oh, okay, thank you for the correction. So, yes. I would enter, but I had confidence, I had self-esteem, and I knew that whatever I was delivering to these boys who were supposed to turn to be priests, who are training to be priests, they are getting a lot of value from me.
Yes, they're actually watching you, some of them.
I know they are watching, thank you. So I ended up teaching them for 1 year, and before I knew it, I was at Makere. And Makere, I did literature English.
Oh, yeah.
When I was almost concluding, the new vision came, please, you come and you freelance. Know. And by then, we were proud. I wanted to go back and teach in the seminary. And please come and freelance with us. And when I came to freelance, you people, I ended up in the children's section and education. That's where I was. That's where my stories were. That's where my interest was. Little did I know I would join New Vision and end up being a children's editor for 12 years. A job I still appreciate up today. I am always correcting and giving. Please, if you had added this, this story would have been the best. You know, anything that concerns children, to me, if it's well done, it gives me a smile. It has no money. Quantity. Yeah, you can't pay me for loving children and your management. But do the right thing. Let that child smile.
Yes.
You've made my day. And we are about to make children smile in this
country. So, Dr. Mganga, we actually running out of time. And I want you to emphasize on this, on how, before I get to Auntie Vita now, our children today are just, they just put things in their heads. Right from kindergarten, primary, to the level of probably university. And now you're saying you are a big advocate of saying, you know what, we should get out from the other side. How are we going to start this?
You know, two ways. I mean, I am a firm advocate of transformation education.
Yes.
An education that is authentic, that mirrors real life. All right? You can't live in an artificial environment and expect to live in real what?
Life.
Darkness and light. Don't do what? Work together.
Don't connect.
You're now, not compatible.
Yes. Now, let me tell you what is very, very important that people do not pay attention to. And if His Excellency the President talks about transforming or overhauling, I like the word overhaul, not reform. We have been reforming and reforming and reforming. See where we are. 200,000 students graduate every year. Maybe 20,000 jobs are created. 180,000 will never have a job. And the cycle continues. Yeah, so really we can't reform. We should overhaul, transform, upside down. Now, there is one important thing, Jovita here will carry this message, I think, make another article and write and edit it, right? Parents, wherever you are watching us, if your child is not in any way involved in some technology sort of, they're not getting any digital skills in any way, in any school they go to. Just know that one of the inheritance you're giving your children, that is the worst you have given them, and it will torment them. We live in a digital economy world. If you look at the last 4 years, right? There are certain jobs that no one knew that they are there. But today, they're here. Big data analysts, app designers, or developers, web analysts, bloggers, vloggers, digital strategy, e-commerce consultant, cloud services specialists. If you asked Aunt Jovita here and myself, as we went to senior one, I was 1992, I guess. I was in senior one. I didn't know anything like this. And not even a president of that time knew anything like this. Indeed. They were not there. Now, what has technology brought for us? Now, people have started talking about the metaverse, the virtual world. trying to go and attend concerts in the virtual world. You go virtual to school reality. At Harvard when you are seated in your living room in Kampala, somewhere in Chisenyo, whatever, if you wish. But you are attending with the students who are in Harvard in the same class, thanks to the metaverse, virtual world.
Yes.
That's the technology where we are going. Jovita talked about sending these kids, even when it is not just part of the curriculum, to go out there and learn these machines, appreciate them. There is a new language that has come up. It is called coding.
Yes.
It's not going to be spoken, but it requires you to do what?
Yes.
To code.
Yes.
So how are you going to learn that? Yeah, it's unfortunate. It's not me who is going to live in that world. It's not Jovita. It's not Miles. It's not. These kids have to live the next 40 years. How are they going to live in a digitally taken over kind of universe? So therefore, my appeal goes to government and even us, heads of institutions, because there are certain things we have to do without even asking for government to give us money.
Yes.
We just have to change the mindset. And once we change the mindset, we change the curriculum. You don't ask government to give you money to change the curriculum.
Yes.
No.
Mm-hmm.
To change the mindset of your teachers. No. To bring in things that actually transform people's lives. No, you don't need government to give you money. Change the mindset. But as long as we still think and we are educating people as if we are educating ourselves of our time, then we are ruining this country's most precious resource or asset, the human capital, the people. So therefore, government needs to invest in much internet infrastructure. Too much internet infrastructure.
Okay.
Now, why? Because if I want to be an engineer, for example, if I want to become, study something, you just simply log in to edx.org or mit.edu. They are going to give you all these programs to study them for free. Yes, you go there and check for free. Berkeley, for example, for free. Now, if I can study those things for free, do you know the only thing I need? I need technology to access them. I need fast, high-speed internet, that infrastructure. I need education data to be given to every student. I need a laptop, a gadget, a tablet, so that means subsidize business people who are bringing these things to the country, such that they are, or manufacture them from here, find a way, right? We can, such that these gadgets can be accessed by our students to prepare them for the world they are in or the future. Once we have these things in place, it means these theoretical things or practical things, someone can teach them for free elsewhere. But what we are missing is to do the experience, because no one is going to teach experience. That's what Jovita said. Go somewhere and get a mentor and learn how to do these things.
As early as possible.
As early as possible.
Yes.
Otherwise, you expire before you start. I'm telling you, you're going to expire before you start. Yes,
expire before you start.
Yes,
you're going to get experience anyway.
No, you go to university and study things for 3 years. When you're finishing your degree, the shelf life of a skill has expired. So you need to go back and re-educate yourself. So what are we doing to our children? So we cannot, as parents, we should know what to advocate for. As students, know what to advocate for. You ask yourself, no university student, no parent, most especially in the urban settings, for example, that doesn't have the most computer with the highest computing power called a smartphone. But are we using them to study?
No.
There's no policy that is actually helping us. Even the heads of institutions of different universities, tertiary institutions, are saying, no, keep your phone under. If you remove it, we are going to chase you out of the water. That is dangerous. The benefits, find better ways of managing these gadgets, using them. The way we develop our curriculum or the instructional design should be in such a way that someone is excited using this, solves the problems you're giving them, and it is now a learning tool, not a distracting tool.
There you go. Angelina. Of course, I gotta go, but I like the word. I'm sure you actually, I see you super excited, saying, you know what, these are the words we need to hear. Our children, you know, she does, like, she moves different schools. She has a Jovita Foundation.
Oh,
talking to kids. Now, this is very good. I'm sure she's picked one or two. And when she goes back to, you know, different schools, we say, you know what, guys, we need to do this. Am I right?
I really need to thank God who has given me an opportunity to have visited all the regions, almost all the regions in this country, except Bundibugyo, where I haven't been. Mm. But Bundibugyo, I'm coming. I'll come soon. I'm coming. I'll come and check on you. And of course, with all this, we need to really appreciate also the government, the efforts they've tried to put in place.
Yes,
we
yes.
have a system that is from pre-primary
correct.
To tertiary.
Exactly.
Yeah. And if you're very lucky, you can even get your PhD here in Uganda
yes.
from Makere.
Yes.
And once you get it wherever, you can even teach at Harvard, you can teach at Oxford.
True.
We have a system that is also good. But what we are saying, let's not just do it. Robotically,
we just
teach and children enroll from this level to this level. What are they gaining? Okay. What is their take home?
Correct.
And we are saying, please let's try to nurture these talents and have these children placed in their right space.
Okay. Thank you, Anjovita. I think we gotta go. Last one, Doctor.
Thank you. So, a simple one.
Yes.
Like I said, I pride myself in saying, because I know we are doing something right.
Yes, yes.
That meaningful education begins with us at Victoria University.
Yes.
We are changing the graduation tradition, and we have opened it up to the public.
Oh, you have?
Come and be the witness of what you will see. Let's rewrite the history of the graduation tradition together. And let's celebrate the talents, the passions, the interests, the abilities, the competences, the skills of our students and all the artists in Uganda here to tell you their story. That is, they were not fools. No mother gives birth to a foolish child. No, they give birth to a musician, a lawyer, a medic, a footballer, everyone. No one. It's only one thing that school makes them feel that they are failures. The letter F, which I say, that letter F should be transformed to mean find another answer.
Yes.
That's what we do at Victoria University. So welcome to the VU Grad Festival, September 3rd. Do not miss at 1. It's open to the public.
Invite Jovita as well?
I want to invite Jovita and thank her for your service to this country. And thank you for committing your life to developing the most important resource we have in this country, the children. They are the country.
Yes.
Remember the statistics we have. Over 70% of Uganda's population are young people.
Yes,
if someone commits to those people, what you have done, if there's a better word to more than a hero, I would say that. So thank you very much. Keep it up. We are here to support you.
Thank you.
Wow.
I need also to say just 3 things.
Yes.
That my vision is to see that we have a model school in all the regions.
Okay.
So that we don't have to rush all our children in the center.
We
can still have model schools wherever we are.
You don't have to leave Fort Portal to
you
come to
You don't
Kampala
need to leave Hoima to come to Kampala. You can go to St. Andrea, you can go to Mandera, you can.
Yes.
We have these schools, they just need to be given support.
Okay.
And then, talent incubation centers should be regionalized because children shouldn't be coming to Kampala because they are coming for an incubation.
In
our regions, we should have these talent incubation centers where children, however humble they are, can access these centers. Then we need to have more resources, both human and financial, before we do the overhaul.
Okay.
Let's not just jump on it.
Yeah.
Let's prepare. And of course, let's not leave education to the likes of Dr. Lawrence.
True.
Also as parents, when we've paid tuition, when we've paid school fees.
Follow up. Thank you. Yeah.
And find out what is your child learning.
Very true.
What is your child interested in? Don't leave all this baggage on the administrators.
Thank you.
We should take part in it. And once we all combine our efforts, we are going to have a very beautiful generation.
Very good.
Thank you very much. Of course, we're going to go. It's about time where we, you know, man, we have just started and we have to go. Interesting stuff. But we will definitely have them back one more time to talk about so many things about education. And we are telling you, you can still follow us on our socials, like I said, Urban TV, of course, that's Twitter and Facebook as well. Definitely we'll catch up with Dr. Mganga at Victoria University and Jovita. What's your office once again?
At Auntie Jovita Children's Foundation, Ruth Gardens, Kisasi.
Okay, have a great day and bye-bye.